All right, so now you're waiting for some much better news, aside from that last video, which was so, like, I don't know, I'm sorry. I was just bogged down by the drama of the deaths, you know, the terrible deaths of all of these animals across the planet. They're horrible, horrible, heinous human beings creating these terrible... Yeah, so it just affects, you know, it's tough to stay away from it. And I'm like, oh my gosh. I'm like deep into this retrograde actions happening. And then I'm just being bammed with the worst videos, the worst sights to see of animals. And in my life, you know, it's just awful. And it's just like, I just want to, I really, you know, I'm not a killer. But I, you know, I want to take that person and kill them. You know, it's that type of thing, you know. It's insane. It's insanity what they do to the animals. It's pure insanity. So it just takes away from everything normal, you know. It takes from your normal jurisdiction of yourself, you know. You put you in a state of shock. That type of thing. So yeah. Anyway, so I really wanted to talk about this big Jupiter and the retrograde. And funnily enough, they can say no, there's no way the planets can affect the wind cycle of activity here on the planet, but I don't know. Just as retrograde began, a huge storm, a massive storm, with winds of 20 miles an hour, 20, you know, plus. And I'm like, how is this possible? It's been going on, you know, since retrograde time for like a week. And it's almost like that Dune movie, you know, we have to live inside the houses, we're not allowed to go out. Because it's just the terrible storms, you know, the sandstorms will kill us. It's the only way to survive is to be indoors. So it's that type of life here in Jupiter retrograde. Now, I wanted to talk about Jupiter itself, you know, the planet. Now, Jupiter doesn't have a choice. You know, the planet itself is just a ball. It's just a sphere there. It's not actually the one who is the blame for the retrograde. It's just the ball that's stuck in the orbit. So any ball you put there would do the same. But Jupiter is the one, well, it's Jupiter causing this retrograde, but in reality it's the orbit surrounding Jupiter that's causing the retrograde. And of course Jupiter has its influences because of its size, its weight, its density. But in reality, we need to look more closely, I think, at the gravitation there, you know, the its ozone, those types of factors, and all of this pull and this might and this weight, because that is what's affecting our planet. It's not necessarily, you can't just say, you know, cast a stone and say it's Jupiter. It's in its environment, you know, it's the environment that is causing it. And that is what is so incredible. You know, you can say, oh, it's Earth, you know, Earth is causing this or Mars is causing that. But each one, you know, we have our own little ecosystem and that we're orbiting within. You know, our certain amounts of turns and blah blah blah, but all of this is the jurisdiction of that your troposphere, ionosphere, all of your little spheres there, your ecosphere. It's all there. It's all because of, you know, your particular air, your gases, those molecules, and how they're interacting. So I don't want to just all the time say it's a Jupiter retrograde, because in a way Jupiter doesn't have a choice. It's just at the whim of the orbit. Okay, it just doesn't have a choice. It's not like the planet just said, hey, I'm going to turn around now. It's just like a ball that's in one of those drains, you know. You put the ball in the drain in the water, and it just keeps spinning around. It has no choice. It has to follow that water flow down the drain. So that's what's going on there. So in this effect, though, it has been tremendous and intense. I hope you all have felt it. I felt it. It's just been like, aside from the wind, it has been intense, like just a heavy input. What do we call it? Like a clustering at you, like a compression, like a compression algorithm is heading our way. But yeah, we're being into that. So and so this whole time I'm really like trying to notice changes in behavior, changes in personalities, and I'm seeing even in myself the jump into the shallow. I'm seeing the jump into the shallow self over the choices of just the normal, rich, deeper self. I'm seeing myself jump into a shallow self. Now, the shallow self is protected. It's a protected place. It's a protected personality. But it's one that doesn't give anything as a human being. It just is. Everything is safe. But yeah, that's part of the introversion caused by this retrograde, is we do have a tendency to jump into our shallow selves. So we have to really force ourselves to maybe we're afraid of making mistakes or something. All of a sudden, you know, we feel this impension. I don't know if impension is a word, darn it. I should have learned that through my SATs, but yeah, impension. It is like an impending claustrophobia. So yeah, with that, the shallow is surviving, you know, much easier than, hey, you know, let's get into the nitty-gritty of this. The nitty-gritty is just a tough haul. It's a tough haul to find. Yeah. So to get to it, I'm forcing myself to do, you know. Oh, my dad tonight, he played the Carmen de Maya style flamenco. It's just amazing. All of these things that dig deeper, that bring you back to a life reality, you know, a life reality. Because, yeah, we feel sideswiped by this event. Sideswiped. And so anyway, yeah, I know. I really feel like I have not helped animal rights at all. I just feel like I have not helped. I've been out here, and they are still in their terrible. And it's no good for me to just be, you know, in my waning emotional state. It's not helping them. You know, we have to have strict rules, you know, strict rule sets. And my strict rule set I came up with was just not trade with them anymore, boycott them, try as much as possible to stop buying from them. And I really have to say Korea, Cambodia, Thailand, the Laos, the Indonesians, the Chinese, and I don't want to talk about the Japanese so much, but I know they're involved in take, you know, a lot of taking of the animals, they're not treating them well also. But those specific countries, that certain southern sector just that lives above Australia, you really have some atrocious habits. And yeah, anyway, that's all I can say, is just stay away from it and you might feel better. I wanted to talk about pesticides. Yesterday I was a mess. I want to talk about pesticides, and we're at this state of... I found a wonderful site. I'll try to get the link again. It was a person who had gone through and they listed most vegetables and fruits, just how much pesticides are in, a difference. Like this one might have 70 pesticides and that one has 50 pesticides present, different type of pesticides. So it's not just like you can say that's one company and one pesticide. It's like 50 in a zucchini that's conventional, you know, or 71 in an apple, a Fuji apple or something. So yeah, so you have to go through all of these. Each one has a different pesticide amount. And so I'm really like, okay, so there's the conventional, and it's still staring me at the face. I go to this Whole Foods, or I go to the organic section, even at the Walmart, or I go to the Sprouts. The conventional is just there, and it's just like too plentiful, and it's too on display, and it's too like at the ready and at the whim of the others to take. You know, we do not want people taking conventional. Conventional, what is the point of it? To have this buildup of heavy metals in your system. What is the point? Why would you want the heavy metals that don't leach? They do not leach out. I mean, I don't care if you drink the eight glasses of water a day like my mother did. They do not leach out. Heavy metals clump on. They clump on, and they're very difficult to get rid of. It's one of the worst things we can ever do to our bodies, is put an additional heavy metal. We already have our metals. We already have gold inside us. But we don't need to put more. We don't need to put more of the metals. You add more metals on. It's just like, okay, here I am, Libra, I'll tell you. I'll try to find a pretty pen. I never have a pretty pen, so here I'll use my makeup stick. Okay, so here we are. Okay, this is like a weight. Okay, so now, no, so I'll take this off, because in a way that's the after. Okay, so here it is. Let's say this is your body. Everything's going fine. You know, you're having organic vegetables, organic fruits, organic everything, and is going in there, and everything is fine, and your balance is fine, and you even have metals in here, your own metals you were born with, your metals that are even in fruits and vegetables naturally from the soils. So you're like, okay, cool, da da da, you know, life is great. And then all of a sudden you say, I'm going to take conventional now. I want conventional from the Agriculture Society of America, the Agriculture Society from France, Agriculture Society from England. I'm just so excited. So I'm going to take those, because they're cheaper, aren't they? They're like half the price. So I'm going to take those now. I'm going to put them in my body because I think it's really great. Okay, so here it is. They're going in my body. So now here I am before, and everything was balanced. But now I have an extra heavy metal, so we're going to see what happens. Oh my God! You see this? This is an imbalance in your system. You added those pesticides. You added those metals. Your teeter-totter is way upset. Okay, so now you're like, how do I get rid of it? I put all of that in my system. How do I get rid of it? And lo and behold, I'm sorry if you have mercury in your teeth also. Or gold fillings. Okay, so here. What the heck? How do you get rid of it? Mr. and Mrs. Cancer, how do we get rid of that? It's like adding rockets into our own system. It's kind of scary, isn't it? So I'm like, well, water, 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 make it go away. Oh, you can try. A lot of water. But dang it. Yeah, so that's our upset. That's simple. And so when you have that going on, so this was the before you, and you're like, ha ha ha, I'm just like a funny person, la la la. And then, no. You know, you turn into like Android self. And Android mean, Android nasty, Android inhuman. what are we becoming? Are we becoming robots in a way? You know, more and more, I'm a chip. I add myself to the motherboard. Pretty soon, they just slice me open and stick me on. I mean, that's how much heavy metal some of these fruits and vegetables have. I mean, it's just atrocious. So, yeah. Anyway, it's not gone by just drinking water that quick. It just doesn't go. So this is the danger. This is the danger of our ready-made foods, our ready-made restaurants. We have so many restaurants that don't even bother. They're just, oh, I'm a restaurant, go out and eat. Not any of them have organic on their menu. It's just like, what the heck? I have to go to like New York, Manhattan, to some little select little place off of Broadway somewhere, and it's like, oh, organic only. Or I have to go down to deep downtown Berkeley, organic only. I mean, in the rest of the world, it doesn't have any. In the rest of the world has never heard of this. So no, restaurants are not helping. Our lovely, beloved restaurants. Every time you go there and you eat anything, it's just gonna be conventional, you know. And conventional is not good for our health. You know, it's just not good for our health. I hope you can see that now. So here we have a world of people now. They're all lopsided. They have their lopsided body situation, their little cells. Have all of these little things extra added into, and I'm like, well, so now I'm talking to you, and I have to look at each human being now as a conventional human being. So you can only expect a conventional answer if you ask a question. You can only expect a conventional idea if you are interested in their ideas. They will only feed you conventional. Now, that conventional is not necessarily sane. That conventional is not necessarily safe. It's not necessarily good. It is an imbalanced person. It's imbalanced according to our body regulations. So the conventional person is imbalanced. I'm sorry. You say that person is not sane. You say this person over there is not sane. That conventional person, those 100 people walking into that restaurant each day, they are not sane. They have tapped into their body system, the regular of it, and they've altered it themselves. They've altered themselves and upset their everything. It goes into the brain. You have the blood-brain barrier. Well, heavy metals march right through. They don't care. They're going in. So yeah. So a conventional person. And you want me to see eye to eye with you? I don't think I can. An even vegan person, or even a vegetarian person, good for you. I love that you are that. But you may be conventional vegan, or you may be conventional vegetarian. Therefore, you are imbalanced still. So your thoughts are modified by the additional intake of pesticides laden with heavy metals. So I don't know you. I don't understand you. Do you get me? Do you get my drift? I don't believe we will ever see eye to eye. I think we will only be at misunderstanding state. There are those who live there and even have more, you know. What do I have here, Mrs. Heavy, today? I have a little star. There you go. Yeah. Put my star belly snitch on. That's some serious heavy metal, isn't it? Anyway, no. For stars of China, for the gurus, we have to, or not the star of China, the star of India. We have to be much closer there, I know it. But, any hoots, I don't know. It's not funny. It's just not funny how tainted. And then everything is tainted, you know, from your urines to your excrements. It's all tainted. You're all just, your heavy metal droppings, your heavy metal pesticides heading down into the waters. I don't know. Everybody just clean up their act? Yeah, my Mr. 9 o'clock is saying it's no longer the hour of the monkey. No. It's not the hour of the monkey. No, it's no longer the hour of the dog, I'm sorry. It's the hour of the, we're heading into the hour of the pig. The little piglet, 9 to 11. And interestingly enough, we can go back to 9-1-1, 9 to 11 on the zodiac is the time of the piglet. With the Chinese astrology. Very interesting, isn't it? That day chosen, or I don't know. Yeah. So maybe that there was something else added in the hour of the piglet, also a direct attack. Anyway, let's remember this about heavy metals and how much they hurt. Any hoot, yeah. What am I? In my 50s. And so in my 50s and alone, because I believe there's very few people on this planet with my particular embryonic mindset. So therefore I am alone, and that's life. Anyway. Maybe if the stores help out, you know, if you walk into the grocery stores and it just said organic everywhere, and I never saw that word conventional for a minute, you know, maybe, you know, there'd be hope, you know, there'd be some kind of a real, you know, a camaraderie, a real friendship, a real communion with other human beings. But right now, I just feel like I've just got heavy metals surrounding me, you know, walking down the streets, driving in their cars, you know. Who are you? You're just heavy metals. Too heavy for me. Just too heavy. All right. Enough of Miss Nature. No, there'll never be enough of Miss Nature. Never. Miss Nature is always correct, and you know it. Good night.